Hi friends, so today I am coming with a new video. This video is actually a remake of one of the older videos which we did in Malayalam. Since some of my friends have requested to make that in Hindi or in English, I thought of doing that in English itself. And so this project or this video is regarding the backup for your home router or modem using your existing power bank. Many of the homes may have the inverter facility, but some of the homes may not have the inverter facility. So in this time of this lockdown, everyone is depending upon the internet very much. So this during the power shutdowns, it will be an interruption to their work. How to avoid that one? So using your existing power banks, you can build a circuit for that one. So let me introduce what all are the components which I used for this project. First and foremost thing is the MI power bank which I am using. This is a 10,000 mAh power bank. You can use your own power banks depending upon the rating of your modem. Currently the modem which I am using is a 12 volt 0.5 amps the rating modem, dealing modem. And the next circuit, the next important thing is this is a USB cable. This is a normal USB cable and one of the end I have already cut like this. And there will be four wires, and from that we have to find the positive and the negative. That you can very well find out using the continuity check from here. These two holes, right? This will be relating to the positive and negative, and you can check the continuity in the other side and easily find out which of the wires are the positive and negative. Okay. And the next one is this. This is a 12 volt pin cable. This which we I am using to connect to the modem. Okay. And now the main component of the circuit. This is the one. This is a 5 volt to 12 volt converter, DC to DC converter circuit with a variable output. Okay. So what this will do is like this will be having an input of 5 volt and this output will be giving 12 volt. And there will be a potentiometer over here, this one, this blue one, and there will be a small screw over there. That is actually a variable thing. So depending if you adjust that screw, the output voltage will be getting varied. Okay, and this is another telephone splitter box which I am is already there in my home. Which this is I am using to keep the circuit inside this particular box. And along with this, we obviously need the soldering iron for this small soldering purpose and the multimeter for checking the voltage and also the continuity. So these are the basic components. So let me explain what the circuit will do. Okay, this circuit, if you observe closely, we can see there are two in ports and there will be two outputs. The input will be obviously the 5 volt input, and what the circuit will do is like this will amplify the output to the 12 volt, and depending adjusting the potentiometer, we can correct the output to our desired value. Here in my case, the modem is having a 12 volt, so I'll be adjusting the output to the 12 volt itself. So how it will happen is like now the USB cable here, which I already shown, right? This USB end I have to connect to the power bank, and this cut wire end I will have to connect to the input two terminals, and from the output terminal I will have to connect the 12 volt DC pin cable, and this has to be connected to the modem. So now let's see how this we will be doing, and let's see how this circuit. So right now we have connected our circuit. So this is the input of the circuit, the power bank. From the power bank you can see the USB cable that will be connected to the input of our DC to DC converter card, and the output 12 volt, and the 12 volt cable is right now connected to the modem. Okay, so now the modem is getting power on from the power bank. So usually the power bank output will be 5 volt, and using the circuit we have boosted it and we have changed that to 12 volt. And depending upon your modem rating, you have to check with the compatibility of your power bank. Right now you can see this potentiometer over here, a small screw over here. Maybe the first time when you connect, the output may not be 12 volt, it will be more than that one. So you have to adjust the screw and make this output 12 volt. Right now I have set this to 12 volt, and right now I am connected my modem. So with the circuit you can very well connect your power bank during the time of power cuts. And this 10,000 mAh power bank, once up it is full charge, I will get almost 6 to 7 hours backup. Almost my power bank is almost old run. I have been using that for a long time. Maybe a fresh one will be having even better backup. Maybe more than average 8 to 9 hours you will be getting with one 10,000 mAh. So
That's quite handy nowadays in case of the frequent power cuts or in case of an emergency meeting, some urgent work, so that the power interruption may not interrupt your work. So I hope this video will be useful to many of you, my friends. So thank you everybody for watching my video.